This is an extra video for the final exam from the spring of 2007. It refers to a question that was not asked in the final but could have been asked and is the kind of question that you can expect to see on quiz 3 in the fall of 2009. In the last part of the problem, we were looking at oblique incidence. We had the expressions for the perpendicular reflection coefficient and the parallel reflection coefficient. These are reflection coefficients, as usual, that refer to the electric field. But we were not asked to determine the electric field for these two cases, nor were we asked to determine the magnetic field. So if we move to the next page, these are two figures from our textbook from Oblique, showing on the left the electric and magnetic field configurations for parallel polarization, and on the right for perpendicular polarization. Okay, in both cases, you notice that we have propagation at an oblique angle given by theta incident and reflection at, again, at the same angle. So we have theta 1 on one side and theta 2 on the other side. Okay, so in order to represent the fields in these regions, we're going to have phase terms that look like e to the plus or minus j k dot r, where k is a vector, and this became kz for normal incidence. Okay, so in the incident field case, k incident, you notice, is going at this angle theta I. So it is partially going in the x direction and partially going in the z direction. And in the case where the angle of incidence is equal to zero, we expect this to be in the z direction. So these are going to be multiplied by a cosine or a sine. So this becomes a cosine of theta 1. And this becomes a sine of theta 1, and they're both positive. So you can see under the condition where theta 1 becomes 0, k ends up being in the z direction. So this is all multiplied by k1. All right, for the reflected wave, pretty much everything is going to look the same, but you'll notice that up here that it now goes in the negative z direction and the positive x direction. So this will be x, this will be minus z, and again essentially the same numbers, cosine theta 1, sine theta 1. We're still in the same region, and therefore it's going to look the same. And again, K1 is omega square root of mu 1 epsilon 1, and K2 is omega square root of mu 2 epsilon 2, just for completeness. For the transmitted wave, this will look exactly like the incident wave, except now we have theta 2. Oops. And I have to actually write down what I mean. So that's the sine. So this is what the k vectors look like. In this case, that would be used in all of the phase terms. So in the next video, we'll look at what the unit vectors will look like in front of each of the vector terms.